In the third episode, I've shown you how to create a Dixon shader already. But can it make a beautiful Dixon like this? Let's remember how we did it. A noise texture will be combined with the original alpha map to act not only as a dissolving map, but also as a new alpha. The alpha clip threshold property determines the minimum value of visible alpha, and we created the dissolving effect by increasing this property over time. We also selected the areas about to be clipped by the dissolving map and blend the albedo with a new color to highlight the edge. But this method cannot be applied in every case. Let's take this beer bottle as an example. It has different transparency levels for each point. So, if we apply the previous dissolve shader, the beer bottle turns into an opaque version, not being able to express the glass material. If we duplicate the dissolve shader and change the render mode to transparent, the beer bottle becomes too transparent, especially the paper label. It can be seen through now, which is the unintended size effect. Huh? Why does it happen? The transparency is controlled by the alpha map. By modifying it for the dissolve shader, we change the transparency too. For opaque objects, this change doesn't affect the original material, because there's no transparency there to control. But with a transparent object such as this dear spirit, the dissolve map is also the alpha map. This is a huge disadvantage when we use the alpha clip threshold to create the dissolve shader. Furthermore, even if we want to, we cannot use the alpha clip threshold in the sprite shader graph, because the master node of these shader graphs don't have any port for alpha clip threshold. That's why we need another way to create the dissolve shader without using the alpha clip threshold. What? Our new goal is to create the second dissolve effect without using the alpha clip threshold while maintaining the original alpha for visible pixels. In the nerdy time section of the full video, I show you two ways of rendering the gonad focusing on the invisible parts. The first one is not render them at all by using the alpha clip threshold, and the second one is still render them with alpha set to 0. From this clue, we know that without using the alpha clip threshold, the only way to hide the pixels is setting 0 as their alphas, and this is how we process the alpha values. For pixels having alpha lower than the threshold, the alpha will be overwritten by 0, and for pixels having alpha greater than that, the alpha will remain the same. So, we need to check if a number is less than another number or not. We can use a step node to do this. It produces 0 if the in number is smaller than the edge number, and 1 if the in number is greater than or equal to the edge number. We have a graph representing the alpha values from 0 to 1 at the top. The set function in the middle graph produces 0 for values under a threshold and 1 for the other cases, where the values are greater than the threshold. By multiplying alpha with the step output, we can override 0 to values under threshold while maintaining the original alpha values above the threshold. It's basically what happens when you multiply a number with 0 or 1, and it's exactly what we need to process the alpha values to hide the pixels with low alpha. Let's compare with the original core idea diagram to see the differences between our methods. Our new method does not use the alpha clip threshold property to discard low alpha pixels, but I will still use that parameter in the step node to reuse the animation. Both these two methods rely on manipulating the alpha channel, but the new one only changes the alpha for invisible parts. By duplicating the dissolve subgraph, we can freely edit it to create another version of the dissolve effect. After creating the dissolving map by combining noise texture with the original alpha, the step node will have us compare the dissolve map with the alpha clip threshold. Only the white pixel will be visible. I ungrouped these two nodes to move them into another group later, and we'll modify the original alpha map by multiplying it with the step output. That's how we hide pixels by overwriting alpha with 0. Yeah! The rest remains the same. and you can remove the alpha clip tassel in the output because we don't need it anymore. Congratulations, you've created another version of the dissolve effect which can be applied to transparent objects. I'd like to push it further a bit to create a more performance version by replacing multiple notes with just a single one. Currently, we are combining remap with saturate to convert the alpha into the mixing ratio between the edge color and the albedo texture. A smooth step note can do this task too. Even better, the remap node converts a value in an input range linearly to another value in the output range. If the input value is not in the expected range, the output value won't be either. That's why we need to clamp the result with the saturate function. On the other hand, the smooth step node can really ensure that the output value stays in the range of 0 to 1, so we won't need to use saturate to control the value range anymore. Moreover, the values are not just remapped linearly, but with easing in and out. It makes the value change gradually, much less rigid. Both the inner and outer ring of the above circle are quite easy to identify, but they are much harder to be recognized in the below circle, because the color blends slower in the beginning and in the end of the gradient. The smooth step comes with its easing effect by default, and it's cheap. The easing principle was already introduced in the second episode, so if you don't know what it is, just watch my video for more information. Let's replace the combination of remap and saturate by the smooth step node. It remaps a value between the two edges to a corresponding value between 0 and 1 with easing. So we can assign the alpha clip threshold to the port H1 and the edge threshold to the port H2. The input is still the alpha map. These ports can be connected directly, so we can remove the vector 2 node. That's how these 4 nodes can be substituted by just a single one. The output of the smooth step can be split into 3 segments. It produces 0 if the input value is smaller than H1, and it produces 1 if the input value is greater than H2. The input values in between will be remapped to a number in the range of 0 to 1 smoothly. I've explained this part carefully in the full video, so I will focus on the difference this time. These 3 segments are very close to the ranges we use with the step node. They produce 0 and 1 on both ends. The only difference appears in the middle, which is the highlighted edge area. Over here, the step node's output is always 1, while the smooth step output increases from 0 to 1. If we use the smooth step values at the alpha factor, the pixels will fade out more if they are near the edge. It makes the effect even more beautiful. So why don't we replace the step node by the smooth step node? Let's do this in the shader graph and it will become much cleaner. This is a new way that my dear spirit will be solved. All the visible pixels will have their original alpha unchanged. The core concept is still the same. 1. You hide pixels with alpha values under threshold by clipping or overwriting alpha. 2. You increase the threshold from 0 to 1 over time to create the dissolve effect. And 3. You highlight the edges by converting alpha into the mixing ratio by the combination of remap and saturate or the smooth step node. The new subgraph can be used in the sprite analyst shader graph too, and that shader can be applied to any 2D sprite or UI image on the canvas to make them dissolve. I use them to make various scene transition effects. The only limit is your imagination. There are also many aspects of this effect that I do not mention here, such as visual effects, discerning direction, blah blah blah. And if you want to know more, please find my free full video on the channel Avalanche.
Thank you.